Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build my 6x3 zipper door, which you can see here right in front of you. This door deviates a bit from my usual doors since it is not the most compact, it's not the cheapest one and it's not the most beautiful one, but it has a very interesting to look at opening and closing sequence and might be fitting right into some kind of theme for your map or whatever you want to build. Anyway, let's show you this in action. So as you can see, we have this 6x3 opening here or doorway here, and on each side we have a bit of a left out space in the wall and a lever. And if I flick the lever, this thing here starts to open up in this nicer looking zipper way. So as you can see, we have the teeth of the zipper here going on, which are, even if it's opened, partially visible, as you can see here. And if I flick the lever, it also closes, as you can see right there. So that's basically what I want to show you today, and that's the general idea behind this entire thing. Anyway, let's start with the sizes. So the entire thing fits within a 3-wide wall, so it's just 1 block wide. It's a total of 7 blocks high and a total of 28 blocks wide, so pretty wide for a simple 3x6 door, but that's basically what you get when you have flying machines going from both ends. Anyway, that's the sizes. Now let's get to the required resources. So that's of course some building blocks, then 30 obsidian blocks. That's already counting the obsidian blocks in this frame here. If you want to continue on the walls as a 3-wide wall or 3-deep wall, you will need of course some additional obsidian blocks since there are slime blocks involved when the flying machines move. Anyway, additionally you're gonna need 2 snaps, then 16 slime blocks, and for redstone resources it's 2 redstone blocks, 17 redstone dust, 4 redstone repeaters, 4 observers, 4 node blocks, 8 sticky pistons, 2 hoppers, and a lever as an input. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's quickly show you how to build this door here. Okay, so the first step is placing down the door frame, made out of those 2 brackets of obsidian blocks or another immovable block. They are, as you can see here, 8 blocks wide and have on the left side at the bottom here an additional block, and the top one has on the right side an additional block, which essentially forms the 3 high, 6 wide door frame right in the center. Following that, let's go on the top here and let's start on the left side with 4 blocks, as you can see here, followed by a hopper. Then put redstone dust on top of those blocks. Now we need a raised block, lowered block, and another raised block with a repeater on 4 ticks running into it, as you can see here. Then place 2 upside down snaps followed by another hopper, as you can see here. Again, redstone dust on top of those. Now a raised block and lowered block with another repeater on 4 ticks in this direction. Next to the block we need a sticky piston facing downwards with a redstone block below it. Then diagonally to the redstone block, an immovable block. And then diagonally to that we need a node block down here. Then let's go on the right side here. First we need a raised block, lowered block, raised block, lowered block. Put a repeater on 2 ticks in this gap. Then we go down a layer, then up again, place a row of 5 blocks in total here. Then we go down, place 2 blocks, down a single block there. Put a repeater on 4 ticks on this block, then redstone dust on top of all these blocks here. Next grab a node block, place it below this block, in this block. Place a sticky piston here, then we need, with a 2 high gap below that, another node block. Place another obsidian block right there, and a redstone block below the sticky piston there. Then grab a lever, place it on this line here and turn it on. Now it's time for the flying machines. Let's start on the left side with observer looking at this node block and another one looking at the hopper from below. Now place 9 blocks to the front of both, then 2 sticky pistons in this direction and another one in the opposite direction down there. Next a row of 6 slime blocks in front of this sticky piston there. Now with 1 wide gaps in between, another 3 blocks down there. Now on this side we essentially build the same flying machine, so just place the 2 observers, as you can see here, then again the slime blocks, the 2 sticky pistons in this direction, and in this direction, the other one. Now again, 6 9 blocks to the front, and this time we have the blocks on top. As you can see here, then let's see if everything works. And that's what we want to see. Now let's see if this also works properly. And that's looking good so far, which means now it's time to start filling in the rest of the frame, which can look similar to this right here. So as you can see, besides of the 3x6 doorway, I also left a 2x3 on each side, so you can see part of the flying machines, or when the door is opened, you can actually see half of the door segments in the zipper configuration right there. But it's also possible to just close it up completely here and there and just have the doorway. Also, it's pretty much up to you what you want to do on the sides. If you just want to have a 3-wide or 3-deep wall, all you have to do is fill this with blocks. Just make sure that you have immovable blocks up to this position right there, since there are 9 blocks involved. And on this side, it's pretty much up to this position, and this if you are having this down here in a visible kind of way. Anyway, that was basically how you can build this 6x3 zipper door. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!